For 10 years, the classic TV show Happy Days was a huge hit with its mix of rock and roll music and 1950s American nostalgia. Now, who could forget characters like Richie Cunningham, Ralph Mouth, and of course, the Fonz. But a huge part of the show's success was the lovable Mrs. C, played by actress Marion Ross. I recently spoke with Marion, who's just as sweet in real life as her character on the show. Marion Ross, welcome to Backstage. You're one of my favorite TV moms. It's a pleasure having you on the show.
Oh, Tim, I love Boston so much. I love you.
Well, thank you very much. I'm going to take that as a great compliment.
You tell them your mother is very proud of you.
What was it about Happy Days that was so special in your mind that made it appeal to so many people for so many years?
Well, first of all, it was a call back to the 50s so that kids would watch with their parents and say to their mother and dad, was it really like that? Was it really like that? And they would say, yes, it really was like that.
Now, listen, I want to tell you about your date, okay? Now, she's a very cute girl, but she's not your usual type of girl.
Mm. It would always start in Arnold's with all that music, and then we had the Fonz, so we had about six different things that made the show such a success.
Oh, it's my fault. I drove him out. I probably said, sit on it, Howard, once too often.
What did you enjoy most over the years about playing Mrs. C? Because you had a very special relationship with all the characters on there, all of the actors as well.
Well, they would come to me and ask my advice, you know. Aaron especially spent a lot of time in my dressing room. And Ron would come and stand in the door, you know, and have a chat. Asked me things, and the Fonz also, and it just was very comfortable for me.
The police are after Fonzie. Run out and up the stairs and tell him he'd better take it on the lam. Oh, good, you're leaving.
I mean, it really was real to me. Oh, well, I said to the prop man, can I make some of those cookies with the little M&M's faces on it, you know? And it was like playing house.
Richard, please postpone your demonstration till after the election, and then we can all get arrested.
And you know, we had a softball team. We all had uniforms. We played softball in all the major league fields in the U.S., and that kept the cast together.
I imagine you still stay in touch even to this day, then.
Oh, very much. I talked to the Fonz yesterday. I talked to Tom Bosley yesterday.
Oh, what's the difference? You're the Fonz, and I'm Cookie Cunningham, and I'm 45 years old, and I'm never going to do anything great.
There was something very unique about the show in that it spawned so many others. I mean, Laverne and Shirley came after that.
All right. Laverne. This is Laverne DeFazio. She's mine. And this is Shirley Feeney. She's yours, as you can see. Mm. Hey, plant it here, girls. Plant it here.
Joni loves Chachi. And even beyond
That's right.
Yes, more than Mindy. I mean, this show that you were a part of really sort of laid the groundwork for a lot of popular shows to come.
It really did. And, you know, we had Tom Hanks was on our show one time. We had a lot of, I can't think who they are today, but we have a list of people who became very famous who were passing through Happy Days on their career.
Well, one thing that really stood out about the show as well was that Henry was kind of a breakout star. You were all wonderful as an ensemble, but Henry became quite popular as the Fonz.
I know an old man who split when I was 4 years old.
Your father?
You know what he left me? He left me a strong box and no key. I had to run over that thing three or four times with my tricycle. And I finally sprung the lock. You know what was inside? Yeah, the key, and that's it.
I understand at one point the network really wanted to even make him more of the focus, but that he was really reluctant to do that. You were a true ensemble in that sense.
That's right. They offered Henry his own series called The Fonz. And, but by taking him, if they took him out of the family, you've changed the dynamic. The Fonz worked best if you've got this tough guy who really is a very sensitive person on the inside, put him inside this family. Like, so they said, how many people would let a motorcycle guy live up over their garage?
You took this cool cat off the street and put a roof over my head. Not to mention an occasional warm meal in my tummy. Who wrote this, hey? All right, cool. But more than just making a home for me. You befriended my bike. Hey, that was great. I want to...
You as the mom had a certain connection with Henry Winkler's Fonz as well, because you were the only one that was able to call him Arthur and get away with it.
Arthur, yes, right. So I had a very special, because he didn't have a mother. So he was treated me with great gallantry, and that was lovely.
Here's your thermos for work, Arthur.
How difficult was it for all of you when Ron Howard left the show? Because he was another linchpin of the show, and to have that leave the show must have left a great void.
These are wonderful questions you're asking. It was like, oh, we thought the show might come down, you know, but it didn't. We kept it going, but it never was the same again.
Excuse me.
Yes?
Have you ever used this?
No.
No? Oh, well, I have. It's very, very good.
Marion, it has been a pleasure having you on the show. Again, you're one of my favorite TV moms, and I want to thank you for being on Backstage.
Thank you, honey. These are wonderful questions.
Well, that's it for this special Beatles and Bandstand edition of Backstage. I'm Tim Estiloz. We'll rock out the show with some more great music from Beatlemania now. Take care, everybody. We'll see you next time.